Hello friends, I am your friend Rahul and I am back with this new video. Till now we have learnt about refraction by glass slab and concave lens. Now it is turn to learn about the refraction by convex lens. In today's video, we will do an activity to learn refraction by a convex lens in a better way. To perform this activity, we need a convex lens with a focal length of 15 cm, a stand, a screen, a candle and a sheet. Remember, we saw different cases of image formation through a concave mirror. Here too, we will do this activity in the same way. First of all, we draw a straight line on the sheet and mark a point in the middle and name it O. F1 and F2 are inscribed at 15 cm on either side of O. And 2F1 and 2F2 at a distance of 30 cm in the same fashion. Then place the lens on O and place the candle on one side of the lens and the screen on the other side. Like in the case of a concave mirror, the object was kept at 6 different positions. Here as well, 6 different cases can be made. The first at infinity, the second beyond 2F1, the third at 2F1, the fourth between 2F1 and F1, the fifth at F1, and the last between F1 and O. Case 1. If the candle is placed at infinity, the light coming from the candle will be parallel to the main axis, and after refraction, the image will be formed at F2. The image will be highly diminished or point-sized as well as real and inverted. Case 2. If the candle is placed beyond 2F1, after refraction, the image will be formed between F2 and 2F2. The image will be diminished as well as real and inverted. Case 3. If the candle is placed at 2F1, then the image will be formed at 2F2. But its size will be the same as the size of the candle as well as the nature will be real and inverted. Case 4. If the candle is placed between 2F1 and F1, then we will get image beyond 2F2. It will be larger in size and real and inverted in nature. Case 5. If the candle is placed at F1, then the image will be seen to form at infinity. The size of the image will be highly enlarged and the nature will be real and inverted. Case 6. In the last case, if the candle is placed between F1 and O, then the image will not be visible on the screen. But it will appear that it is forming somewhere on the same side of the lens as the object. Size will remain large and nature will be virtual and erect. In this table, summary of image formation by convex lens is shown. Convex lenses converge the light. They are used as magnifying lenses or camera lenses. They are also used to correct defects of vision, which will be studied in the next chapter. We have learned so far about mirrors and lenses. Let's try to remember all the points by creating a comparison table. Number 1. In the case of mirrors, a glass piece is polished to make a mirror. And here, any transparent spherical piece of glass is known as spherical lens. Number 2. Mirror always reflects the light, but the lens refracts. Number 3. Mirror can either be spherical or plane. But in case of lenses, there has to be two surfaces, and either of them must be curved inwards or outwards. Number 4. Mirror works on the laws of reflection, whereas lens works on the laws of refraction. Number 5. There is only one focus and only one reflecting surface of the mirror, whereas in the case of a lens, there are two. So friends, in our next video, we will learn about the lens formula. Take care folks and keep watching our videos. Take care.